Four is the number of life and death. Four runes in endless spirals are beginning, destiny, fate, and end of man's body and soul. Four are the directions from which the wind carries the dust. Four, the number of elements from which we are spawned and to which we return at the end of days. It is the original number, the number of the kin, father, mother, son and daughter. It is the number of the seasons of man and earth. Fourfold are the sides of the solar cross. It is the number of the rivers upon which life draws. Earth, he did not create it as a wasteland, but as a homestead. Suns it raised and exalted, but deaf to its commands, they went their way. And it said, "Mankind, you've struggled with all those words of advice. Let them step up and save you. The stargazers. The sky conjurers who prophesize doom to you with every new moon." And it awoke. Earth, sun, moon, and stars to punish mankind. Einstein has fallen. Newton has been bent. False gods to strap onto beasts of burden in the cities, torn and desecrated. Four is the number of the riders, and they herald doom, as there are four masters of immortality, so close to Earth, biding their time in damp chambers. But they will awake with true intention. To build the city, it said, four-sided like a pyramid, and in its shadows truth will thrive. Alpha and Omega, beginning and end, life and death. Eight is the number of the Creator, who descends from up above. Mankind will wonder, its name uninscribed, into the book of life since the world began. As it looks up to him, who was and is not, of the infinite, of he who comes and goes, he with whom everything rises and with whom everything falls. And earth may gape open and salvation may bloom. Eightfold, the lotus leaves uncurl wherever the wind blows. Eightfold, like the wind rose's arrows, its pollen spreads, spewed skyward with relish. Eyes, legs, everything, eightfold. She rises from the dark, climbs the highest mountains, and blocks the deepest valleys, hunting for the sixfold ones. Eight is her number. 12 is the number of the tribes the jackal consorts with. It sleeps amongst them and feeds amongst them. 12 are the moons, too, dividing the year. 12 the temperaments that free the mind from the crowd. 12 is the number of the zodiac whose children slumber fitfully in everyone, waiting to be unleashed. Buried within the number, both creators' names. Hope and despair are the sum of 12. When the perfection of unity rushes the mind of every being of the threefold four. By air and sea and on earth. 16 is the number of the stranger, the newcomer. 16 are his revelations. 16 is the number of his heralds who devastate the land. 8 plus 8 is the number of the two creators, fighting for dominion. 8 plus 8, two infinities, consuming eternity in their conflict. Instinct versus intellect. Flesh versus spirit. Chaos versus order. One and six is the number of the people that will fight for the crown. One and six is the number of the plagues that ravage them. One and six are the points of the axis drawn upon the enemy's skin. One and six, the breeding chambers, the veritable hell, will rise from. Four times four is the number that completes the solar cross when all things return to their point of origin and the circle closes forever. Time terminates itself.
Everybody, what's going on? Welcome back to take number two of our Degenesis PC creation tutorial. We recorded one a couple days ago. Had some information wrong in it, so we wanted to get this one back out with the updated information because we want to be right the first time that we do this. So yeah, we're creating this just for people that are curious about how you create a character and also for my players in my upcoming Degenesis game. So first off, what is Degenesis, in case you're wondering? Degenesis is a primal punk role-playing game by Six More Vodka. They are an art studio out of Berlin, Germany. They put out some amazing artwork and content. I definitely suggest you check it out. You can go to degenesis.com. They recently released all of their product free to play. So you can pick up all the PDFs completely for free. If you like what you see, which I know that you will, you can buy physical copies of the books. You can donate to the website. They sell their art prints. They've got some shirts. They even sell some vodka, which is kind of cool. So yeah, definitely check it out, degenesis.com. The introduction stuff that you heard, that is some videos or some audio video teasers that they put out. So we're gonna jump into this first. We'll give you a little more in depth as to what Degenesis is itself. So I'm just going to pull one little paragraph out of here. Degenesis is about hope and despair. It is about people and the conflicting priorities of human civilization, daring to ask how far our race has truly come since we climbed down from the trees. The world of Degenesis is like a ruined Garden of Eden, containing the secrets and spoils of both good and evil, of ignorance and enlightenment, of barbarity and virtue. So Degenesis is about a post-apocalyptic Europe that takes place around year 2500 and some change. Asteroids have plummeted to Earth, destroyed pretty much everything, but inside of the asteroid something much, much worse has appeared. So it covers humanity's survival amongst themselves, and then also with what the asteroids have brought. It is broken up into two books. The Rebirth Edition has two books, each one 350-ish pages, so over 700 pages of content. Primal Punk has to do with your lore of the world. It goes over your cultures, which would be like your race, your ancestries. It also goes over cults, which would be like your class or your paths, and then also the history of the timeline of the events that occurred up until present day. We jump over to book two, which is called Catharsis. And this has to do with more of your game mechanics. And that's what we're going to be using. Game mechanics, character creation, battle, which rules for combat, bazaars, where you burn stuff. Burn is a drug within the game that has certain bonuses, side effects, that kind of stuff. From Hell is like your bestiary, telling the story. That's going to be GM tips. And Into the Dust, that is the adventure that we're going to be playing whenever we start. So we're going to jump right in here. We're going to jump and look at your attributes. On your character sheet, you see that you have 6 attributes: body, agility, charisma, intellect, psyche, and instinct. They're kind of broken down here. Body is your physical force, tenacity, and stamina. Agility is about being nimble, being able to dodge, manipulate complex mechanisms, and ranged weapons. Charisma is being able to just, you know, be likable, open up certain doors in the world, diplomacy, negotiation, stuff like that. Intellect is about abstract thinking, concentration, that kind of stuff, technology, science. Psyche is your mental strength, and instinct is kind of like that street smarts, reaction, that kind of stuff. Then they jump down into your skills, which you see here. They break down each attribute into skills underneath that. So like athletics, brawl, you've got under body, crafting, dexterity, projectiles under agility, your conduct, expression, leadership, seduction under charisma. You've got your science, medicine, engineering, artifact lore, etc. under intellect. Your cunning, deception, dominance, willpower, and whatnot under psyche. And then empathy, perception, survival under instinct. So when you're creating a character, we're going to jump to what they call the 3 C's. We're going to go through 6 steps, the first one being the 3 C's. Your culture, which is like your race or your ancestry. Your concept, which is what drives your character. What is the motivation behind your character? And the cult, which would be like your profession, your class, your path. So with each one of these, you get... it allows you to increase the maximum points that you can put into each character's attribute or skill. So when you're building a character, you get 10 attribute points to distribute among the body, agility, charisma, intellect, psyche, and instinct, with a maximum of 2 per attribute that you can put in. Your culture, concept, and cult will allow you to go above that 2. One important thing to note that we misunderstood when we first read it, the additional skill points that it allows you to put into it is not bonus points. You only get 10 attribute points. The bonuses just simply allow you to put more than 2 in those attributes. You get 28 skill points to put into the skills underneath the attributes. And again, the bonuses allow for you to put extra points above the 2 that you are allowed to put in. And you'll kind of, we'll expand on that a little bit once we start assigning our points. You'll kind of see what we mean. Also, something to note whenever you're creating a character. You see here we've got primal and focus and faith or willpower. Your character is either one or the other. Primal is they kind of let their emotions take control of them. Focus has to deal with your rational sense. You're able to keep your cool. Then we jump down into faith and willpower. Your faith is you believe in something. You believe in a higher faith. Something is driving you. Willpower is more of internal. You believe in yourself, and that is what pushes you. All right, so what we're going to do here, the Catharsis book, it has a little step-by-step guide of how to create a character as they kind of build one out, a chronicler. We're going to go a little different route. So what we're going to do is we are going to jump over here. And first part of the three C's is our culture. So we are going to go with Borka. And you see here that they have a list of common cults. You don't have to stick to this specifically, but one thing that they note in here, the lore in this game is very in-depth. So if you create something out of the ordinary, you better have a damn good reason as to why you're doing it. So we're going to go with Borka. You see we get a +1 max to the attributes on agility and instinct. So we're going to make a little note of that. +1 to agility and instinct. And you see we get a +1 max to the skill bonus of toughness, artifact lore, engineering, crafting, and survival. All right, so now that we've got that noted, now we're gonna, so the cult we're gonna go with is we're gonna go with the Helvetics. The Helvetics, they are, we'll jump over to them real quick just to kind of show you them. They are more your Spitalians are kind of like your medics. Let's see here. Let's get to the Chroniclers. They're like your gatherers of information. And that's a really summed up version. These, as you can see here, they go into great depth on them. The Helvetics, they're more of your military type. Which kind of drew me to them. I really, really liked their doctrine. It's, when I was reading through this, it really, really spoke to me. I really, really dug it. And that's their weapon there, the Trailblazer. All right, so we're going to jump over to our cult now. Nope, I'm sorry. We're going to grab our concept. So let's see here. So we are going to go with the Mediator is what we're going with. All right, so we're going to jump over here, find the Mediator. It gives a +1 bonus to psyche. And a +1 to perception and negotiation. All right, so we got that straightened out. All right, so next we're going with our cult. So we'll jump here to the Helvetics. You see we get a +1 bonus to our force, our stamina, our leadership, our projectiles, and our reactions. All right. So let's see here. So we'll jump back over to our three C's. We picked our culture, our concept, and our cult. So we got that straightened out. We made a list of our bonuses that we're gonna get. So our culture is Borka. Our concept is the Mediator, and our cult is the Helvetics. Let me just make sure that I... Helvetics. Yep, there we go. All right, so we got that straightened out. You see I got our name, age, and whatnot here already. All right, so what we're gonna do now is we're gonna go ahead and following the three C's, we're gonna spend our points. Remembering we get 10 points to go into our attributes and 2 points or 28 points to go into our skills. The skill and attribute maxes 2. Our culture, concept, and cult allow us to add a +1 to the maximum that we can put in there. Not additional points, just a +1 to the max. All right. So body is obviously very important. So let's see here. And we get... a bonus to body... some reason I thought that we were allowed to put more than that in there. Let me just verify that real quick. Mediator is a +1 to psyche. Helvetics, Bod Force, that. And let me just double check my Borka. Okay, so now we don't get one. We overlooked that. All right, so let's see here. So we're gonna bump 2 into body. Let's see here. All right, so there's 2. We're gonna dump 3 into agility. All right, so as you can see, we've got our 2 here that we're allowed, and then the +1 to our max from our culture. So that's a total of 3 so far, or 5 so far. We've got 3 more points. Let's see here. So we're gonna go... so I know we're gonna do instinct because he is gonna be a bit of a hothead. So that's a total of 6. I'm gonna do 1 into charisma, and 1 into... we're gonna go 1 into intellect. Nope, we're not going to go into intellect. We're going to go into psyche. Yeah. All right, so we've got a total of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 5, 6, 7, 8. All right, so there's our we get a total of 10. Get a total of 10. See here. I was looking at page 8 was what the attributes is on. So we're going to drop 1 into intellect. We're going to drop we got a 3 into agility. We're going to drop another one into our let's drop it into instinct. Yeah. All right, so we got 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. All right, so we got our 10 skill points, or 10 attribute points. I'm sorry. Yep, 10 attribute points. All right, so now we're going to do our 28 skill points. So let's see here. We're going to jump over here. They kind of give a breakdown of each one. Athletics, climbing, running, jumping, swimming. Running, climbing, jumping, swimming. Yeah, so he is kind of soldiery, so we're just gonna start by dropping 1 into that. Brawl, definitely we're going to drop 2 under Brawl. So we're at 3. We're going to drop, let's see here, Toughness. It's got to do with physical regeneration, withstanding pain, environmental influences, stuff like that. So yeah, we're gonna drop a couple into Toughness. We may come back and add some more. We'll see. We're going to drop 1 into Melee. Force is going to be how hard you're going to hit something. And Stamina. Got to do with tracking, diving, marching for hours, holding your breath. Yeah, we'll drop some into that. All right, so we're at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 5, 6, 7, 8 out of our 28 allowed skill points. All right, so Dexterity, we're gonna drop 2 into Dexterity. We're gonna drop 1 into Navigation. Projectiles, we're gonna drop 3 into that. Not sure why that happened there. All right, we got 3, 4, 5, 6. 4, 5, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. All right, so we're up to 14 now. Stealth. Yeah, we'll drop 1 into Stealth. Why not? You never know. Mobility, that sounds like it might be kind of important. Escaping, art swimming. That might be kind of useful. So what we're going to do, let's just add 1 into mobility. If we need to swap some points out, we can later. So leadership's probably a good thing. Let's see here. We're going to go with, let's see. We'll come back to that later. Let's jump into Instinct. We're going to do some into Primal, 2 into Primal. So we're at 20 already, just to kind of show you how fast it goes up. Going to do 1 and 2 survival. Because remember, it's either psyche and faith or willpower. So we're going to drop 1 into willpower. And then it's intellect and focus, or instinct and primal, and we're going primal. We're gonna go drop 1 into domination, drop 1 into cunning. Let's count our points. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24. So we've got 4 more points to spend. Let's see here. Toughness, we've got 2 in that already. We're going to go ahead and add another one into that. So that brings us to our 2 that we're allowed, and then a plus 1 to our max. We got 3 more. Projectiles, we already have at 3. I'm not really worried about crafting. Let's see here. Perception. Yeah, we're going to drop 1 into perception. That might be kind of useful. So we've got 2 more. Leadership, we're gonna leave leadership at 2. Reaction. Yeah, reaction would probably be kind of good. We're going to drop two into that. All right, so that's should be our 28. Let's see here. 28. So we've got that done. We'll jump back over here to our three C's, to our character creation steps. See what the next step is. We spent our points. So step number three is spend points on our backgrounds. Backgrounds, we get 4 points to spend on 6 backgrounds. No trait can go above number 3. Check off my steps here. All right, so we're going to jump to our backgrounds. All right. So we're going to go with authority. That seems kind of important. We're going to drop 2 into authority. Let's see here. Gonna go renown and allies. So even though he is a bit of a hothead, he has got some friends and has kind of become known. So that's our four points for our backgrounds there. All right. Now we've got that. Let's see what our next step is in our character creation. Determine the rank. All right, so once we assigned all our points and we've got all our stuff assigned, then we get to jump to our cult and figure out what rank we start out at, which will determine our starting equipment. All right, so here we go. So rank number 1, soldier. No prerequisite. We automatically are a soldier, so we automatically get a trailblazer. Go ahead and add that to our weapon. That is the Helvetic's weapon of choice. All right. Plus 5 rounds of ammo per month. They get a harness. And they get some rations. All right, and we'll get the stats from the Trailblazer once we get done with this here. All right, so our corporal, the prerequisite is we have BOD plus force, at least 4 points into that. So we're going to jump over here. Our BOD and our force, we've got 3. And 1, so that gives us our 4. And what that means is when I call for a force roll, you would roll 3d6 here and then another d6 for a total of 4, because that is, you got your 3 here and then your 1 and 2 into force. So we're good on that. Agility and projectiles, we need 5 in. Agility, I've got 4. Projectiles, I've got 3, so that's a total of 8. So we're good there. Now, one thing, if you notice here, they give you 1 point and everything automatically for free. So that's where while I put 3 here, we do have a total of 4. So we're good on the projectiles. Instinct and survival of 4. Our instinct has 3. Our survival is 1, so that gives us our 4. And our authority, we need 2. And authority, we have 2. So we obtain the rank of corporal. We get an additional 10 rounds of gear. We are able to get a level 1 upgrade for our Trailblazer weapon, which we'll cover that later. And we also get permission to carry 2 units of an explosive of our choice, which sounds like a lot of fun. All right, so we got the basic down. We got our Trailblazer, our harness, our rations. When we get past that, we'll grab our stats and get that information filled in. All right, so we're going to jump back and we're going to see what the next step of our character creation is. We determined our rank step 4. Now we're on to step 5, our potential. Kind of like a feat, an ability of sorts. So let's jump to that. They've got general potentials, but then they also have cult-specific potentials. So we are going to go with, we looked, and we're going to go with assault. The prerequisite is that we're primal. We are definitely primal. And it gives you a little description of what this potential does. So we're going to copy that. Put it on our character sheet. Just like so. And I believe, let me double check how many points we get in it. We get a potential level 1. So there we go. All right, so we got that taken care of. So that's step number 5, our potential. And now we are on to the last step, our step number 6, our finishing touches. So let's see here. Jump through that. You can see kind of the different cults here. Let's see here. Tailors. And here's the common potentials that I mentioned. All right, final touches. So your ego. Is fueled by either intellect and focus or instinct and primal. All right, so we went instinct and primal, so it'll be instinct and primal times 2. So our instinct is 3, primal is 2, so that gives us a total of 5 times 2 is 10 ego. So we'll go ahead and fill these in. 5. Oh, there we go. All right. Let's see here. Next is our spore infestation limit. Your spore max is your psyche plus either your faith or your willpower. Remember, it was one or the other. We went willpower. So our psyche plus willpower times 2. So 2, willpower is 1, so that's a total of 3, times 2 is 6. Alright, there we go with that. Next, we're going to go to our flesh wounds. Let's see here, is our bod plus toughness times 2? Our bod is 3, toughness is 3, so that's a total of 6 times 2. Which is going to be 12. All right, we got that. Next is going to be our trauma. So once you've taken a certain amount of damage to your flesh wounds, then it jumps over to trauma. Is our trauma max is our body plus our psyche. We've got 3 and 2 for a total of 5. Now, one thing I've noticed when reading through this is not like your normal D&D games where you sleep 8 hours, long rest, you're healed completely up. No, that is not the case in this. As in real life, it takes time. It just, you're not going to get all your hit points back from by taking a nap. Sorry, not gonna happen. Which is one thing that I like. Goes over your defense. Everybody's passive defense is 1. Next, we're going to do our money. So, our money, let's see here. Goes by resources and your rank. We did not put anything in you add your rank number, which we are a corporal, I believe it was. I'll double check that here real quick. Yep, we were a corporal, which is rank number 2. And if we had resources, we would add that together. So if we had our rank is 2 and we had 1 in resources, that would give us 3 times the number here. But we only have 2. You've got chronicler drafts, which is money issued by the chroniclers. Then you also have dinars, which is an African currency. We're going to use chronicler drafts. So we are Helvetics. We take our rank number 2 times 50 for 100 chronicler drafts, which is our starting money. We put that right there. Weapons and armor, we're going to jump and kind of fill that in. And then that is it. So let's jump to the bazaar, get that information filled in. All right. They go over all the different cult equipment. They break it down by the cult. You've got your different. It gives you what your trailblazer is, what it does, the different types of ammo that you can have to it. It really, they do an amazing job of breaking down everything that you can get. Let's see here. All right, let's see here. So this is your melee stuff. And so here we are with the rifles, your agility plus projectiles. It tells you as the stat. So our trailblazer is your high frequency full jacket. The distance is 30 and 120. Handling was nothing. Your distance is 30, 120. Our damage is 11, and our magazine's 35. The qualities are smooth running and salvos. Right. Let me go ahead and close that so I don't keep clicking on it here. Encumbrance is 2, tech is 4. And our slots is 2. All right, we'll jump over to our harness. Let's see here. Armor, harness. 5 is the armor rating, and it is fire resistant. Fire resistance of 8. It has an encumbrance of 3, tech of 4, and slots 2. 3, 4, and slots 2. And then our rations. Let's see here. Let's see if they break that down. I know they've got like food and stuff here. Fishing gear, flask, cooking equipment, water, traps, sources of light, tracking, climbing. They don't really have any of that, but you can see they break down a lot of different stuff. They've got your suit mods, your heavy duty modules. Some neat stuff here. You can see the mods for your armor, your guns, your melee weapons, and whatnot. So let's see here. We don't have any artifacts. No modifiers or complications at the moment. So yeah, so that wraps us up. We are done. If you have any questions, please feel free to leave them below. I will get them answered the best that I can. And be sure to check out our Degenesis game that will be taking place on Sundays at twitch.tv/fshmo. You can subscribe to us on YouTube, which is where you're watching this video. So definitely check us out there. You can check us out on Facebook, facebook.com/fshmo. Same thing with Instagrams, the same fshmo. Same thing with Twitter, all that kind of good stuff. So thanks everybody for watching. A big thanks to the Degenesis community, especially Gunsmile for helping me out, setting me straight on some stuff that I had some questions on. An awesome community. Definitely check out their Discord. So I hope you like what you saw. And we will see you later. Thanks.